How should the Los Angeles Lakers start to get back to title contention over the next 6 months? LA has the option to clear the decks to make way to add two maximum free agents such as LeBron James, Paul George, and / DeMarcus Cousins, though with plenty of other costs, or take a more patient approach. What does each path look like, and what are the best options? Let's look at all the potential maneuvers and decisions the Lakers will face as they continue to rebuild a team that has missed the playoffs 4 straight seasons. Creating cap space is like putting together a complicated puzzle. For the Lakers to optimize room in July, the pieces will need to fit. And right now they don't. Although the Lakers have only $49.5 million in guaranteed contracts, plus $4.5 million in non-guaranteed salary, the $66 million in combined free agent cap holds has Los Angeles over the salary cap. Rarely does a team get a mulligan to fix past mistakes. Fortunately, Los Angeles is still in position to chase two max free agents in July, even after signing Lowell Deng and Timofey Mozgov to a combined $136 million in 2016. It will, however, come at a cost to the Lakers' depth. Gone will be starters Brook Lopez and Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, key reserves Jordan Clarkson and Julius Randle, and veterans Deng and Corey Brewer. Harry's how, Jordan Clarkson. Moving Clarkson, one of the early favorites for sixth man of the year, and his 2-year, $26 million salary, 2018-19 and 2019-20, is step one, Indiana the Lakers' path to clear room. Although there could be suitors at the trade deadline, as there were for Lou Williams last season, the Lakers would prove prudent in keeping the guard until the summer. Moving Clarkson mostly for cap space in early February only to strike out in free agency would be a serious blow to LA's depth. Julius Randle, you would think that the combination of Kyle Kuzma and Larry Nance Jr. would make Randle expendable. Relegated to backup center after starting 133 games the previous two seasons at power forward, Randle has not only found a role with the Lakers but has proved to be one of their best players. Although Randle's minutes are down from the previous season, 28.8 to 22.3, including a season-low 8 minutes in a win at Houston, the 23-year-old's production has increased, notably posting a career-low 102.5 defensive rating. Randle's biggest attribute is his ability to play the backup 5 when the Lakers go small. After spending 97% of his minutes at the 4 in 2015-26 and 67% last season, Randle is now logging 85% of his minutes at center, according to Cleaning the Glass, and playing 8.4 fourth quarter minutes per game. For the Lakers to optimize Randle's value, the 2014 lottery pick would need to be traded by the February 8 trade deadline. The obstacle Lakers management will face is finding a team willing to trade away a key asset, such as a good draft pick, for a player the team could sign as a free agent in July. However, Randle's bird rights, and, thus, the ability to exceed the cap, have appeal based on the majority of the teams not having cap space next summer. If the Lakers fail to trade Randle, they run the risk of losing him for nothing in free agency while they go star chasing.